Hi, my name is Richard Abadie. I lead our global capital projects and infrastructure business. And today I've got Neil Broadhead, one of our UK capital and project infrastructure partners, with me to talk about correcting the course of capital projects. Neil, welcome.
Thank you, Richard.
First question for you, Neil. What are the causes of some of the problems in big capital projects?
I think what we typically see are the same sorts of issues arising on lots of different types of projects. And probably one of the starting points that I'd want to talk about is what we call optimism bias. And that's really where projects set out with unrealistic expectations around budgets and schedule. And that sets a context where projects can never be delivered successfully. We also see issues around the performance of clients being a very integral part to project delivery, and how clients can be better clients in enabling a project to proceed successfully. And then I think the third area I talk about is complexity, and all of the project organisation and project team understanding the complexity of risk in the context of delivering a project.
So Neil, you've identified some of the problems and what can go wrong in capital projects. How do we go about solving them?
I think one of the key things about solving some of those issues that we talked about is having really effective upfront and early investment in the project process. Effective governance over project delivery is also critical. Often projects start off on the wrong footing, and when that happens, trying to adjust that direction of travel can be very, very difficult. Also, we would always recommend independently testing items such as the project budget and the project schedule to test their robustness. And then finally, we also would encourage all of the stakeholders within a project to be engaged fully with the project team right from the outset all the way through the project life cycle.
What are some of the early warning signs that you see when projects start going wrong?
Well, what are red flags for us are where we see numerous changes to the schedule, for example, or for the budget. Or in relation to changes to the business case. So that's one of the red flags that we look for. One of the other red flags that we look for is inconsistent reporting. And there are many projects and many clients that we've worked with where the monthly project reporting pack will be 100 or 200 pages long. And frankly, that makes it very difficult to truly assess the performance of the project. So we'd look for clear, transparent project reporting.
Based on your experience, can the parties solve this themselves, or does it need some form of external intervention?
Well, in our experience, Richard, getting external intervention is really helpful to the project teams. And in fact, we would say it's critical to have a really independent perspective on how a project is performing. You'll be familiar that often the supply chain for delivering projects is outsourced, and often those relationships mean that some of the parties that are closely related to the performance of the project have commercial incentives, which mean they maybe don't want to present a picture which is fully transparent, and therefore having a completely independent body looking at the performance of a project really adds value in our perspective or in our view.
What lessons can we draw from projects that have gone wrong and how to turn them around?
I mean, I think the first thing to say is that unfortunately many projects do fail against some of the key criteria of performance against schedule, performance against budget, and we've done some analysis recently which demonstrates that in excess of 50% of projects don't meet their objectives. So clearly a lessons learned environment is really critical. However, having said that, often it's not done in a way that is collaborative with the project team or ultimately is successful. What we think is very important that when you undertake a lessons learned exercise is that it isn't an investigation, it's a collaborative exercise that you undertake with all of the project team, and the output from that analysis needs to be hardwired into both the client teams and the project delivery teams to make sure that similar mistakes aren't repeated in the future.
What I take away from this discussion is that mistakes do happen. Close control will help solve them, and more importantly, troubled projects or difficult projects can be turned around. So thanks very much for being here today, Neil. Look forward to catching up again.
Thank you, Richard.